Hello and welcome to Craft with Sarah. In this video, we're going to be looking at a new feature in Design Space, and that is how to search your own projects. So this is a feature that so many people have requested over the years to be added into Design Space, and in January 2021, it was. This is really exciting because it's going to make it so much easier for you to find your previous projects that you've made, rather than before, when you'd have just had to click View All next to My Projects and then wait for it to load and just scroll through everything you've ever made to try and find what you're looking for. Now you can just search for it instead. So make sure the dropdown is set to My Projects, and then in search, just type in what you're looking for. So let's go Card and hit Enter on the keyboard. And now this is showing me all of my own projects that I've made, that I've designed over the years, that have card in the name or the description or the tags. So there's quite a lot. I do a lot with card. So if I try something a little bit more specific, let's go for Wolf. You can see that's the only project that I've got on there that has Wolf in the name. So this is picking up Wolf because I've called it CWS Wolf. If I type in Moon, then it doesn't come up, even though there's a moon on that Wolf image, and that's because I don't use the word moon anywhere on the Wolf project. So if I bring this back up, if I wanted it to come up for Moon, I could do several things. I could change the title to include Moon, so maybe Wolf Howling at Moon, or I could add the word moon to the description. To make changes to the title or description, click on the three little dots and then click Edit Project Details. You can then change the name if you want to, or you can add in the description. So this is really handy on the description because it means you can add more words than you'd be able to fit in just the title. So if there's things that you think you might search for in the future, but you don't want to add it in the title, you can put it in here. For example, for this one, I could put moon in here, I could put howling, I could maybe put dog. You know, there's a whole range of words you could think of to put in there if you think that's something you might search for at a later point. So just to prove this is going to work, let's put Wolf Howling at Moon in the description and press save. And now let's close out of that. And now if I search for Moon, my Wolf appears because it's picking up that description. Now, one thing I'd suggest to make it easier to search for projects in the future and to make sure they come up when you search is to come up with a list of keywords that describe projects that you frequently make. For example, I do a lot of layered projects, so cardstock layered designs like you can see on the screen here. And over time, when you're saving things, you might not always remember to call it the same thing. So maybe one week I make something and I call it a layered design. The next week I make something different and call it layering. And then the next week I maybe call it layers. So that's three different words to essentially describe the same thing, which might mean that if, you know, a few months down the line when I've completely forgotten what I called anything, I might be typing in layered into the search, looking for something specific, and it doesn't come up. And the reason it might not come up would be because I called it layers instead of layered, or I called it layering. So if there are words that you're going to associate with a particular type of project that you make a lot, just choose one word, so let's say layered, for example, and then make a spreadsheet somewhere on your computer, or a Word document, or a note on your desk, or just something that you're always going to know where it is that you can refer to. And then every time you save your projects that are related to those words, you can make sure you put that exact phrase in, which means that in the future, when you come back to it, it's going to be really easy to find all your projects of that particular type because you'll know exactly what word you need to put in there. So this was an overview of how to search your own projects in Cricut Design Space. I hope you found it helpful, and if you've got any questions, then leave me a comment below and let me know. I think that this update, the ability to search your projects, has just been rolled out to the mobile versions of Design Space 2, so you should be able to do it on there, but if for any reason you can't, then I'm sure the feature will be coming soon. It does seem to be that Cricut update the desktop version first, and then the mobile one a little bit later on. So if it's not there yet, don't panic. I'm sure it will be there soon. Okay, so thank you for watching and happy crafting, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel for loads more Design Space tutorials, Cricut projects and free layered designs. Bye!